الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وآله وصحبه أما بعد فيقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الرحمن just before talking about or starting the topic of the, could you please move forward, everybody please, everybody move forward, complete the front rows please. Okay, it starts again then. My dear brothers and sisters, my dear children, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Many people ask questions regarding al-jinn. Who are al-jinn? And as you know, there are two chapters in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that a group or a number of jinns attended a recitation of the Quran by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they listened to it and they went back to their people, we'll use the word people, to warn them. They believed immediately when they listened, they believed, went back to their people to warn them. We also are aware that Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam had or he'd been empowered by Allah to have full control over the jinn and the satans from the jinn. So it is not a hypothetical. Jinn, they do exist. So can someone remind me, were the jinn created before man or after man?
Before man.
What is your proof?
Quran. Actually,
huh? How can you prove that the jinn were created before man?
Jinn first.
Yes. Yeah, where is the proof?
The shaitan is from
the jinn. Exactly. And the shaitan attended the creation ceremony of Adam, therefore the jinn definitely. And Allah also say he created jinn before man in more than one chapter. Okay, let me refer now to Surah Al-Rahman. Chapter 55, the most merciful. Verse 14, Allah says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم خلق الإنسان من صلصال كالفخار. He created man from sounding clay like pottery. You know when you have a jar made out of clay and it is dry and you do this, you knock on the outside, you can hear
the sound,
salsal, okay? This sound. وَخَلَقَ الْجَنَّ مِنْ مَارِجٍ مِنْ نَارٍ. And he created the jinn from smokeless fire, a fire which has no smoke, free of smoke. Let me read the footnote. The creation of man and jinn is contrasted. Man was made out of sounding clay, dry and brittle like pottery. The jinn was made from a clear flame of fire. Yet each has capacities and possibilities which only Allah's grace bestows on them. How can they deny Allah's favors? In Surah Al-Rahman, it is repeated very often, فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. In the dual, the surah is talking to both jinn and ins. And Allah says, فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا. Then what of the favors of Allah would you deny, both of you, in the dual? Okay, let me start with Surah Al-Ahqaf, chapter 46, and listen to what the jinn who attend them. By the way, can we see them?
No.
We can't. Can they see us?
Yes.
إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ وَقَبِيلُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُمْ. He, Allah is referring here to Satan. He and his tribes or his people can see you from where you cannot see them. Can they take different shapes when they? Yes, they can. They can. A black dog or a snake or, yes, they can take different shapes. Do they multiply? Yes, they do. Do they die? Yes, some authentic sources claim, yes, they live for certain time and then they die. Yes. So among them, there are the good and the bad, yes? Okay, now let's listen to what they said. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This is Surah Al-Ahqaf, chapter 46, starting from verse 29, if you want to follow me on your mobile. وَإِذْ صَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. We turn towards you a company of jinn quietly listening to the Quran. يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. فَلَمَّا حَضَرُوا, when they came, when they arrived, when they were there, فَلَمَّا حَضَرُوا قَالُوا أَنْصِتُوا. This is very interesting. They said to each other, be quiet. Listen to the Quran. They stood in the presence thereof. They said, listen in silence. Listen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 204, chapter 7, وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنْصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. You're absolutely right, my dear brother. So when you listen with full concentration to the Quran to try to understand what's being read, what's being said. That's the meaning of al-insat wal-istima'. Listen and try to understand. Concentrate on what you are hearing, what you are listening to. So they said to each other, ansitu, listen, in silence. فَلَمَّا قُضِي, when the recitation was over, وَلَّوْا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِمْ مُنْذِرِينَ. They went back to their people to warn them as warners. They acted as messengers to their people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talks to the jinn and the ends, he says to them, أَلَمْ يَأْتِيكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِنْكُمْ. Haven't you received messengers from among yourselves? So there were warners sent to the jinn. There's no doubt about that. What did they say when they went back? قالوا يا قومنا, our people, إنا سمعنا كتابا أنزل من بعد موسى. We heard a book which came after Musa, عليه الصلاة والسلام. Some people, some scholars say, these jinn were believers in the book of in the Torah. They were believers in Judaism, put it this way. And the other surah, Surah Al-Jinn, they say they were Christians because they were referring to the false allegation against Allah that he has a son. قَالُوا يَا قَوْمَنَا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا كِتَابًا أُنْزِلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مُوسَى. O our people, we have heard a book revealed after Moses. مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. Confirming what came before it. And what are the attributes of this book? يهدي إلى الحق وإلى طريق المستقيم. So this jinn who attended the recitation immediately believed, immediately. They were convinced that this book is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They believed in it and they went back to warn their people and they told them why. Because this book يهدي إلى الحق وإلى طريق المستقيم. This book guides to the truth and to a straight path. Move, come. يا قومنا أجيبوا داعي الله. O our people, respond to the one who invites you to Allah. Who was he? The one who was inviting them to Allah? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And what will happen if you respond to the one who invites you to Allah? يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ مِنْ ذُنُوبِكُمْ وَيُجِرْكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. So number one, أَجِيبُوا دَاعِيَ اللَّهِ وَآمِنُوا بِهِ. Respond to the message.